Happy holidays.
My name is Jordan Kosky. I'm the Mortgage Geek with Kosky Mortgage and Citywide Mortgage.
My name is Bready Wu. I'm a licensed realtor, work for Klein Gurola Page City Center, Sussex. Today, we're going to do a quick wrap-up of what's going on in the Vancouver real estate market in 2021.
And join us while we look into 2022 and talk about that as well.
The past 20 months have been like no others for Metro Vancouver real estate market. A steady recovery was well underway when the pandemic put the housing market and the rest of the economy into a lockdown during March 2020. The lockdown, however, was short-lived. As for the first quarter of 2021, residential sales in Metro Vancouver area were red hot at about 23.9% increase compared to the last year. The inadequate supplies from new construction has created heat in housing markets across Canada, as well as the consumer heightened interest in low-density housing due to COVID-19. It's going to be a sustained pressure on detached home pricing, that we've seen a 10% increase in housing price compared to quarter one 2020. Quarter two was still going strong with 111% sales increase compared to the second quarter in 2020. COVID-19 has made a lot of us reassess our living arrangements and take on the massive sorting process during the time of reasonable affordability. Moving forward to quarter three 2021, we're experiencing a 34% sales increase compared to last year. At the same time, we do see a huge reduction for the people who are arriving in Canada, that's including all the immigrants or temporary permit holders. However, according to the government, we're probably going to expect another population growth in the following years, which would ultimately result in the house pressure in the general market in BC. But due to the supply and demand, there has been a long period of time of underproduction of housing in BC. The new housing supplies are not necessarily in the locations that are needed the most, and the types of housing that are being provided are out of step with what the market requires. Predictions are always difficult. Looking forward, new listings and sales are expected to remain closer to the long-term average, while active listings will slowly build through the fall of 2021 and into the next spring. All right, Jordan, could you please tell us what's going on with the mortgage industry in the 2021?
Yeah, that's a great question. So in 2021, we started off in such an unprecedented time with COVID. So what was going on is fixed rates were at historic lows. That was due to the fact that coronavirus lockdown was still going on. People were uncertain about the economy, that sort of thing. So what ended up happening was by January, February, things started to change a little bit and fixed rates started to increase quite quickly. And then ultimately, as things started moving forward, as we get throughout the year, well, now you'll see fixed rates are much higher than they were at the beginning of the year. Still great overall, but you know, are higher than they were, while variable rates are still at that very low mark. So there's quite a large spread between the two.
Well, as we're heading to 2022 and the spring's coming, what's your thoughts and what you think about the mortgage is gonna be?
Well, that's a great question. So in 2022, what we're expecting is those people that had variable rates, well, they'll continue to save for a little bit longer. However, what people are expecting, well, the Bank of Canada is expecting to push their rates up a little bit further. Some experts are saying it's going to go up by 6 times in the next 2 years, which over 0.25 intervals, well, you'll still save money. However, it won't be at these historically low marks anymore. Mm-hmm. Then, of course, other people, and most people are basically saying, is that 6 seems like way too many, so it'll probably be around 3, and then that seems the much more likely scenario. But we'll see ultimately what happens over the next, you know, few years. I hope you enjoyed our year-end wrap-up.
And happy holidays again.
If you have any questions at all, my name is Jordan Kosky.
My name is Freddie Wolf.
And of course, we'll see you in the new year.
See you next year.